We've all lived in this world for a number of years, and we have a lot of ideas about physics. The good news is, some of those ideas are correct. The bad news is, some of them are probably wrong, and we'll have to fix that in this class. We're going to start off by thinking about velocity. You've probably driven down the freeway at 60. 60 what? If you're in the United States, hopefully, it was 60 miles per hour. What does that mean? Your car goes 60 miles. That's a distance. We can write that as a change in position, or we like to call that displacement. A change in position or a displacement, a distance in some time interval. 60 miles in 1 hour. If we use calculus, we can get the instantaneous velocity by using derivatives. The derivative of our position function with respect to time. So if I'm traveling at 60 miles per hour, how far do I go in 3 hours? Well, we can just rearrange some of the things here. We can say our distance, our change in position, our displacement, is equal to our velocity times our time interval. So if we're going 60 miles per hour and we travel for 3 hours, cancel our units, 180 miles. Some of these units we're already familiar with. So a mile per hour, you know, we're used to that because we drive in cars. We typically measure our speed in the US in miles per hour. But in this class, we're not going to use these units. We're going to use SI units or metric units. So we're going to use meters per second for our velocity. A meter is about this long. And you're going to move 1 meter in 1 second if you're moving at 1 meter per second. Well, think about that for a second. That's just a fast walk. You can take, every time you take a step, it's about 1 meter. And if you're taking a nice long step every second, that's a quick walk. That's just a fast-paced walk. So now you have something to relate that to. The fastest people. We just had the Olympics last summer. The fastest people can do 100 meters in about 10 seconds, less than 10 seconds. So for them to go 10 meters, it only takes 1 second. So the fastest people are running at 10 meters per second. It turns out that 1 meter per second is approximately 2.2 miles per hour. That means that the fastest people on Earth are running about 10 meters per second, or about 22 miles per hour. Just to give you some context. If I were to run, of course I can't run anywhere near 10 meters per second. Let's pretend I can run at 5 meters per second. If I am running at 5 meters per second, and I start at x equals 30. I start at the 30-yard line, let's say, on a football field at x equals 30, and I'm running in the positive x direction. Where will I be after 5 seconds? You're already familiar with one of our kinematics equations. Our position at some time is going to be equal to our initial position plus how much it changed, how much our position changed in that time interval. And we know that the change in position is velocity times time. So I start out at the 30 meter mark, and I'm running at 5 meters per second for 5 seconds, cancel my units, and I get 30 plus 25. I end up at x equals 55 meters. This is probably a good point to stop and talk about units. Every place you have a number on your page, you have to have units next to that number. Every number should be accompanied by units. And you cancel your units and you include units in your answer. If you don't want to write units next to every number, no problem. Leave it as variables. Leave it as X's and V's and T's until the very end. And in the very last step, you put in the numbers with the units and cancel the units appropriately and have the correct units in your answer. I have a few reasons for this. One, a number without units is meaningless. It's very important that people understand units. There have been major screw-ups. NASA crashed a satellite into Mars's atmosphere because engineers used different units and didn't realize it. There was an airplane that had to make an emergency landing because they didn't fill the gas tank right. They filled it with liters instead of gallons and it ran out of fuel. Units, very important. Reason number two is sometimes you catch a mistake when you're including your units. You'll see that you've got the wrong formula. You forgot to square something, or you divided instead of multiplied. And if you're carrying your units along, there's a possibility you could catch a careless mistake. And the most important reason is it helps to reinforce the physics. You're thinking about things in terms of what's actually happening. Instead of just blindly thinking velocity, you're now thinking, when you're writing those units there, meters per second, a change in position over time. It starts to reinforce the physics and gets you to learn the concepts in a more complete way. On everything you turn in to me, all numbers need to be accompanied by units, and your answer has to have the correct units.